Jai Hind class, today we are going to start new chapter of class 7th science physics, chapter number 4, heat. In this chapter we are going to study about why we use thermometer, what is the use of the thermometer and the temperature. So the topic which today we are going to cover are temperature, thermometer and types of thermometer. What are the precautions? Fine. So, let's start with the heat. What is heat? Anything? When there is a change in energy. Heat is a form of energy. Heat is used everywhere. In our daily processes, heat is there. From increasing temperature, even the movement of the fan, our body intake, the food we intake, heat is there. How do we measure heat? We usually feel hotness and coldness according to the season, according to the weather. And that hotness and coldness will explain us how much heat is there. Any change or any form of energy can represent heat. Let us explain you why we are measuring heat, on which basis we are measuring heat, or the touch, is it the correct way or it is the correct process to determine the temperature? Is our touch a reliable source? Do we measure the hotness and coldness on the basis of our touch, how we feel? So let's have a look at one activity. Here we have taken three cups, cup A, cup B and cup C. In cup A we have taken hot water, in cup B we have taken cold water, and in cup C we have taken both the mixture of cold and hot water. So in first we have placed our left hand on the A cup and right hand on the B cup, and then we have placed our both hands on the C cup. So what will happen? The hand, the left hand which was earlier in our cup A, which was a hot water, when it has been immersed in cup C, it will feel the coldness in the hand. And the right hand which he has placed in the B cup and then he has placed in a C cup, earlier the B cup was containing cold water, and when he has placed his hand on a C cup and move it out, it will feel little hot. Although the temperature of a C cup is a mixed water, that means our hand was not able, or we can say our touch is not able to identify the temperature. That means the touch is not the correct way of measuring temperature. Therefore, that means we have to find some another measure, another instrument which can give us the correct measurement, through which we can check the correct temperature, or we can say we can check the hotness and coldness, right? So the reliable measure of the hotness of an object is temperature. We cannot rely on the hotness and coldness. The reliable, the correct measure, reliable means on which we can trust. So a reliable measure of the hotness of an object is a temperature. Therefore, temperature is a reliable measure. These are the few types of thermometer. Now, we can furthermore elaborate what is the temperature and how can we use the thermometer. So, let's begin. What is temperature? How we can measure it? First of all, what makes things hot and cold? It's the their hotness and coldness. How can we measure it? The second question which arises is, what makes things hotter or colder? Is there any specific criteria which makes the thing hotter or the colder? Measuring body temperature. Now, how do we measure body temperature? Through the thermometer. Temperature. As I have earlier told, temperature is a reliable measure to measure the body temperature. Measuring body temperature through the thermometer is a process. Therefore, temperature is also a degree of hotness and coldness. That means, in temperature, not only the hotness, even coldness is being included. We can measure temperature of both hot things and the cold things. It depends on its function. Now, temperature is an expression of heat energy. As I have told that heat is a form of energy. Therefore, temperature is an expression of heat. Now, coldness is caused by the absence of heat. That means heat is present everywhere, whether we are measuring the hot object or even the cold object. We can say that coldness is caused by the absence of heat. Any product, anything, any material which is not have, which does not have heat is called as cold. How to measure temperature? That is thermometer. Thermometer is used to measure temperature, whether it is hot or cold. But there is a big difference between the temperature, the which thermometer we are using for measuring which thing. That means every thermometer has a different criteria to measure the hotness or the coldness. Not every thermometer is capable of measuring hotness as well as coldness. Now, what is a unit to measure the temperature? The unit of temperature is degree Celsius. All the temperature which I measure is in degree Celsius. The SI unit is degree Celsius. Fahrenheit clinical thermometer. The thermometer which we use at home, or we can say when we feel that we are not well, or we feel that we are lethargic, or we are feeling very calmness and nausea, we feel like we are getting temperature. So what we usually do? We take the thermometer. Right? What are the main four precautions? Before using the thermometer, let's check out what are the precautions that has been used before using the thermometer. First of all, the thermometer should be washed before and after use with the antiseptic solution. That means before you the thermometer. Here, as you can see in this picture, the person is measuring the temperature of this chat. So, what we should do? We should, before taking the temperature, we should wash the thermometer with the antiseptic solution, wipe it out, and then use it to measure the temperature. Second thing, the main precaution, these all are the precautions. Right? The second precaution is that before measuring the temperature of the clinical thermometer, right, we should hold it carefully. We should not hold the thermometer with the bulb. That is, we should not hold the thermometer with bulb. Why? I'll let you know after a minute. Now, Fahrenheit scale. This is a scale that we usually use. As we have seen in our homes, even when we say that mom, we are not feeling well, or anyone in a family member that we are not feeling well. So what they usually do? They take the thermometer, keep it in our mouth. For the small toddler, the thermometer should be placed under the elbow, right? But for the normal class 7 students, we can use thermometer to our mouth and then we check the temperature, right? And what we see? How much? How much? 102, 104, 100 degree, right? So that is the Fahrenheit, not the Celsius scale. So we usually measure our body temperature in Fahrenheit at home. But the another main measuring scale is of degree Celsius. Now the clinical thermometer. The clinical thermometer consists of bulb, mercury thread, and the Fahrenheit scale. Right? The clinical thermometer has this bulb which is carrying the mercury. Mercury is a toxic substance and it is a metal which is in liquid state. So, it is a good conductor of heat. Therefore, it measures the temperature of our body. Clinical thermometer. Clinical means the thermometer which measures our body temperature. Right? So, as it is measuring the temperature in a Fahrenheit scale. That's why 100 degree, 102. So in this picture, the mercury goes up to more than 102. That means the person is having fever 102.4. One thing which is missing in this picture is a kink. There is one kink, which is a bulb. Bulb-like structure. I can make it, for example, this is a figure of a thermometer. I am making just a bulb. Here there is one type of bulb which is called as kink. What's the use of a kink? Kink does not let the mercury to fall down. Let me explain you. As I told you, mercury is a good conductor of heat. The precautions which I have explained, that we should not hold the thermometer with the bulb. Why? Because mercury is sensitive to the heat. And if we touch the mercury with our hand, the temperature will fluctuate and we will get the wrong reading. Right? And we should not get the wrong reading. Therefore, we should not touch the thermometer. Otherwise, if we touch the thermometer to its bulb, our body temperature, the actual body temperature and the temperature which will be taken by the thermometer due to our mistake will be different. Third precaution, which is one of the most important precautions, before measuring the temperature, right, we should take care that it will not extend the temperature. For example, I'll explain you. This is the Fahrenheit scale. came. In clinical thermometer, the third precaution which has been taken is that before measuring the temperature, we should take care that the thermometer, the mercury level should be below the 35 degree scale. The clinical thermometer has a range of 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. It has a range of 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. So, when we measure the temperature before it, we should give it 4 to 5 jerks so that the mercury should be at 35 degrees Celsius. Then only we measure the temperature. And the normal human body temperature is used to measure the temperature of the body, human body, right? And what are the main four precautions? The main precaution that we take that we should wash the clinical thermometer before and after use with the antiseptic solution. Secondly, before measuring the temperature, we should give thermometer some jerk so that the range comes out to be at 35 degrees so that we get the clear temperature. The third, we should not hold the thermometer with the bulb. Fourth, we should carry the thermometer gently so that it will not break. Also, mercury, it's a toxic substance. When the thermometer breaks, the mercury falls on the floor. We should not touch the mercury through our hand as it is very toxic. We use some cloth or some sharp thing, or we can take the help of our elder to dispose of mercury. Right? Now, in clinical thermometer, as we can see, there are two big ranges, right? 96 to 98. In between, there are 10 small divisions. Right? So, how can we? For example, in these two, this is 96 and this is 98. For example, this is the thermometer, right? This is the mercury and here it goes. There are 96 and 98. Between these two scales, there are 10 units. Therefore, this is the 1 mark difference, right? Therefore, 10 more divisions will be equal to 2 degree difference, that is 2 degree Fahrenheit, right? And therefore, if we measure the one small division, which is equal to 1 bar difference, it comes out to be 2 by 10, which is 0.2 degree Fahrenheit. It can be used in a measuring Celsius also. The only difference it would come here, 10 small division equals to 2 degree. Then here, if in Celsius, 5 small division equals to 1 degree Celsius. So, 1 small division would be 1 by 5, which is also equals to 0.2 degree Celsius. So we can measure the 1 mark difference for both the Celsius as well as the Fahrenheit scale. Till now we are clear with the Fahrenheit scale. Now the clinical thermometer, as I have told you, it is measuring the temperature of 102 degrees Celsius. 6 Fahrenheit. Clinical. Clinical Celsius thermometer, as I have told you, the range is from 35 degree to 42 degree Celsius. And the normal human body temperature is 37 degree Celsius. And we should take care before measuring the temperature, the mercury should be here at 35 degree Celsius so that we can get the exact and the correct measurement. Now there are two different types of a thermometer. One is a clinical thermometer, another is a digital thermometer. Digital thermometer, why we use digital thermometer? As clinical thermometer contains the mercury and mercury is toxic. And it is also very difficult to handle clinical thermometer if it falls or it breaks. Therefore, digital thermometer is a very reliable instrument because it does not contain mercury and it will not be harmful for anyone. And it is also upgraded and easy to use. Now the question arises, can we use clinical thermometer to measure the temperature of the boiling water? The answer is no. We cannot use clinical thermometer as clinical thermometer is only being used to measure the human body temperature. For example, if you can see in the temperature 98, this is in the Fahrenheit. It is a normal body temperature. Any temperature which is less than the normal body temperature is hypothermic. And those which are higher than the normal body temperature is hyperthermic. Clinical thermometer is mainly used to measure the human body temperature. So, what is the use? How can we use or measure the temperature of a boiling liquid? You see? The answer is laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer is used to measure the temperature of a liquid, whether it is hot or the cold. The second benefit of laboratory thermometer is it can measure the temperature of both the hot liquid as well as the cold liquid. And it is bigger in size as compared to the clinical thermometer. The range of the laboratory thermometer is in between minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. That means it can measure the temperature of a liquid both hot or cold. Right? So laboratory thermometer is used for that. Also, laboratory thermometer does not contain any kink. It does not contain kink. That means, what's the use of a kink? And kink is present in a clinical thermometer. What's the use of a kink? That kink stops the mercury to fall from a certain level. Therefore, laboratory thermometer does not have kink, so it falls on its own. So, what we have learned today, that temperature indicates the degree of hotness as well as the coldness. And we have learned about the three types of thermometer, clinical thermometer, laboratory thermometer and digital thermometer. That is, the temperature is measured in degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit, as well as the different types of thermometers are used to measure the temperature. Those are clinical thermometer, which is used to measure body temperature, laboratory thermometer, which is used to measure the temperature of liquid, as well as the digital thermometer, which is the mechanical thermometer, which we can use in place of the clinical thermometer. Thank you.